Namaste. Wish you all a very happy weekend. Today is Saturday. Hope most of my friends are getting a holiday. And I do work 7 days in a week. But sometimes I get like half day. Sunday half day, Saturday half day. But I'm really happy by Friday that I'll get half day weekend. And I really love walking. I love my work. Especially when you are a yoga teacher and you do lots of physical work and lots of other activities, which is intellectual as well. Sometimes I feel tired but next moment when I don't know from where I get my energy back and I'm back to life. So today I'm doing this video to actually many of my friends, they ask, and that is really a very important question of my life as well. I was asked by my teachers, both when I was doing my diploma in yoga therapy and in my doctorate in yoga from Ishvesa University from Bangalore. Like, people ask, what is the turning point that I started doing yoga? Because somehow till now people look down upon yoga. I mean, they think as if, you know, when you can't do anything else, you do yoga. So, or you are a baba, or you are into spiritual life. But nothing like that. I mean, I myself did my graduation in English honors. Then I took, I did my MBA. I took dual specialization, both in marketing and HR. But somehow I didn't like it. And maybe the terrible job, I didn't find that I belong to that world of showing and, you know, maybe selling and talking where you really don't want to talk that, right? So it means you do not identify yourself with that job, maybe. And when you do not identify, you do not belong, you don't love it. And you should not do anything if you don't love it. Now, after MBA, from my childhood, I am like asthmatic. Mujhe bahut asthma hota hai. Itna ke, like I get 3 times at a minimum in a month. And I'm hospitalized. Any medicine you name, I remember Astaline, something else as I didn't know. Then injections, nebulizations, lots of injection, and I hate injection. Till my MBA, my nana, when I get asthma, I'm straight taken to the hospital, and I'm not in a position to talk because you know what happens, you cannot breathe. Then I normally cannot talk, so I ask and join my hand and with the tears in my eyes, don't give me injection, I don't want injections. But my nana, he never listens to me because he knows that if I get an injection, then I'll get better. But that is a temporary, right? The whole modern medicine is temporary. You cannot get any permanent solutions after that. It's like out of that. Then it was like till the age of 28, every month the same situation. Like lots of asthmatic, lots of medicines. Then I am a really wild child, like stubborn. If I had to do, I will do it. Like, for example, I love ice cream. I don't use raincoat or umbrella. I don't know what's the problem with that with me. Or I don't know, I don't like them. I just, if it is raining, I'll go. And I ride, I had a scooter, so I ride a lot. And so I get lots of dust. So dust is one of my allergy for asthma, one of main reason, then cold. So getting all the time drenched in rain. So that was the second. Third one is lots of stress, as you know. So what happened, my life was not very easy. I do not regret, actually, because I didn't know. I accepted my life like that, like living in poverty, born in a middle lower class or middle upper class, because till now that is a question. Because my father had no money, so he didn't actually support, could not support our study, and I had to depend upon my uncle, and yeah, they supported a lot, but my aspirations were very, very high maybe. So then there was a point I didn't get any support. Then when I wanted to study, I was beaten up at the age of 21, 2 maybe. When I wanted to do my MBA on the admission day, bahut maar pada. And they said, if you want to go home, go out for study, don't come back home. Then I said, okay. And I literally had to leave the house. And it was not easy at all. This story is from like 2005. Then 2006, I got into my MBA admissions, and you know, somehow the MBA went on, and lots of bullying because I didn't belong to a kind of high school where you speak very good English and you know, you dress up. I don't know in India why these things are very, I don't know, still people are like that, you know. How you carry yourself, how you talk, if you speak English, you are very good, if you are dressing up nicely, smart and all. I mean, nobody gets into your head to see the intellect or to see the inner goodness, like how kind you are, how beautiful you are in like inside. So then after all this story, somehow I did my MBA and I continue my stress level like optimum, and my hospital episodes like went on and on. After 2008, I didn't join any job. I was giving examination to doing a government job because my father told, don't go for any private companies. So I was trying every public sector exams, going to Kolkata, giving exams every day. Night you go like 12 o'clock, catch a train, get up in early in the morning, go to the exam place and come back by 2:30, catch the train, and like, you know, in 24 hours you have to complete your journey exam. And I didn't have money also to afford, but somehow it was going on. Then I did my loan, study loan. Bank people actually used to never take loan from a bank. So I don't know what else you do, but yeah, they killed me because I didn't have a job and you have to give the loan back. It took me 12 long years to pay back the loan, and bank was not very nice, no, not at all nice to me. It was really nasty. I was all the time, again after MBA I started continuing my study. My study never stopped, but they really troubled my parents. So there was a time when bank told that they are going to publish my name in the hall of shame, right? Like you were the one where you could not pay back the loan. And my name will be everywhere in the town, published in the newspaper. And the funny part is I have to pay back all the cost that is, I mean, that will, they were, I mean, what do you say, like, all this publication cost or everything I had to bear because I'm the defaulter. Then, and that letter I got when I was actually coming to catch my flight to New Zealand. I was reading that letter. It was really funny. But my, okay, coming back to my asthma story. So when I was thrown out of the house, so there was no point going back. So I mean, I could not go. I was staying in Bhubaneswar. It was like 3 hours of train journey, but hardly I could go. because there was no love. I mean, my parents, they did love me, but we have a joint family. So I don't know, those who are Indian, they understand this one. Living in a joint family, and when you are, I mean, you feel so lonely in front of, like, among others, like they talk to each other, because I am like desh drohi hote hai na, वैसे ही I was treated like a family drohi. Now what I feel like, yes, we are like, I took birth in a family which was not very rich to fulfill my desires or something. I don't know whether that was a desire, but I always had a high aspirations. For example, जब मैं बचपन में बच्ची थी तो मैं फ्लाइट देखती थी, नो, आई यूज टू सी द फ्लाइट्स. सो दे एनी टाइम दे जस्ट साउंड फ्लाइट्स कम, आई रन लुकिंग अप, एंड देयर वेज टू बी खेती होता है, देन द डिवाइडर, आई लुक अप एंड रन, एंड आई डोंट सी द डिवाइडर, आई फॉल, यू नो, आई फॉल अप, देन देर वॉज ब्लीडिंग एंड ऑल ऑन माई नीज, बट हू केयर्स, आई डोंट वॉन्ट टू मिस द फ्लाइट, राइट, आई सी अप एंड रन बैक. देन I mean, this was my kind of crazy behavior towards flight, because I used to think that flight में ना सब foreign जाते हैं, और मुझे foreign जाने का क्यों craze था, I don't know, बचपन से ही था. My father is a carpenter, so we used to have a what do you call them, catalog, then they have beautiful houses, all the catalogs from for like foreign houses. Beautiful furnitures, beautiful houses, beautiful people, white people, and I was I never loved my skin because I was so, I mean, I'm so dark. So dark means I see mirror and I say hi Kali, that's how I greet myself. So it means I love white people. My nana also till now he tells me that you love white people, so you are going to marry a white man later on. Now I mean, I don't have that kind of attitude anymore. Then, what happened in the year 2009, my asthma level went up. Like more and more asthma. So I went to a park to do some exercise. I had a brother who was a martial art trainer. So I wanted to learn actually martial art. But he comes late, very late. I go early in the morning and he comes at 8 o'clock, then he doesn't have time. He's a mechanic, actually was a mechanic, and a driver, he drives his owner or something, then he comes only with him, stays for 15 minutes and takes them back. So didn't have time. So once what he did, he said, okay, you go and do yoga and calm down your mind, then I will teach you martial art. I said yoga. Then in the park in Bhubaneswar, there is something called Infa Park. There used to two aunties, old ladies, who are my teachers. I should not have said that. So they were doing yoga. So imagine my intellect level, my knowledge about yoga. Till 2010, in the month of Feb, I was thinking yoga, only few people do yoga, and they do in a dark room early morning, maybe at 3 or 4 o'clock. If somebody sees them, then they will die, right? So they do yoga in the dark room. Then I thought, why these ladies are doing yoga in an open park? I said, okay, these modern people have no, I mean, they don't care anything, so they are doing yoga in an open park. So anyhow, I had to join because I do respect my martial art teacher a lot. I cannot say no to him. Then I started something called yoga. It was so hard. So hard, I cannot. If you are doing yoga first time, you know how hard it is. My God, I could not do anything. Almost like crying. Yes, you close your eyes and maintain and breathe. My God, how painful that was. But how I could survive for 10 long days. Then I was given a yoga mat, free yoga mat, not a nice one, but a good one. Then I saw the yoga books for the first time. I said, wow, there are yoga books available in this world. Then they told after like 1 month, why don't you do yoga in the university? Then one Sunday, we had to go to the university park. Like there was something called Bharatiya Yoga Sansthan. They do yoga like free, yoga for free. I said, okay, there is another park in the university. So these people want me to do yoga in that park. I said, okay, I will do yoga. Actually, they were referring me to do a yoga course in the university. And till that time also, I was thinking that I will be doing the same yoga postures, what I am doing, like a bit of pranayama and mudra bandha and postures. I'll be doing in the yoga university park. That time it was 2010 actually, I started doing my job as a data entry operator, something called CYST. That was my Nana, he was a local MLA, so they do respect, and he referred my name, so they took me. I mean, I got that job, but I liked it because it was I wanted to do a job. They gave me 7,000 rupees per month. It was great. Oh, hi. It was a long story. And I think I had to go for a dirt bike. There's a motocross going on. And somebody has come to pick me. And I'll continue the story later on. Maybe I will start the story once again. And I'm not going to post it. So thank you for watching. Thank you so much.